डॉक्टर वाहिया, प्रोफेसर आप्टे, फ्रेंड्स, ऑल ऑफ अस हैव बीन ट्रीटेड टू सिंटिलेटिंग लेक्चर्स, फॉर विच ऑन बिहाफ ऑल ऑफ यू आई वांट टू थैंक डॉक्टर वाहिया एंड प्रोफेसर आप्टे. When, as my colleague Lina mentioned, when we went to meet Professor Vahia at his office in TIFR to request him to deliver this lecture, you know, he not only readily agreed, but you know, the sheer breadth of research that he has carried out over the years, and of which, you know, we actually saw only one part, was amazing. And what I found was a teacher's instinct to teach others, to spread this knowledge to others. So he's not only a great researcher, a great scientist, but there's a great communicator that we all saw in his lecture. We at ORF, you know, who established this Center for the Study of Indian Knowledge Traditions, feel that his entire lecture today is a testimony to the purpose for which we have set up this center, friends. The origin and growth of astronomy in India is just a sub-story of the larger story of the evolution of civilization in India. A civilization that is old and that also has continuity, as he mentioned. We need to know what our ancestors produced in the area of astronomy and, of course, in other areas of knowledge. This knowing itself is something that can make us proud. We need to know the subject itself, but as important as knowing the subject, it is important to gain that national pride. What is our ancestry? What is our past? If the past is something that we can be proud of, then, as you mentioned, why has this rot set in today? What is it that we have lost? It was not just pure science. It was science, ethics, a complete worldview of how human beings should live, in which all the yogic paths were interrelated. So, in one sense, yes, you know, the dark period has ended. I agree with you, Professor. Yet, it has not fully ended. In many ways, we have inherited many wrong things that we have not yet unlearned. And that's why we have a big responsibility to not only know the past, but how to use that knowledge to reform the present so that we live a better future for our future generations. That is the purpose for which, you know, this center, with these just some 40-50 people that we have gathered here, it's a very, very small effort. I'm sure Professor Vahia has addressed much bigger audiences, such as at Patkar Hall that Professor Matthew organized. I'm sure you too have you know, addressed much bigger audiences. Ours is a small effort. I am very happy that with each event we are having new people, especially young people, coming to ORF. And as my colleague mentioned right in the beginning, Lina, our effort is to not just understand these specific subjects, the specific knowledge traditions, but how they are relevant to our conditions today. So in this context, friends, I am happy to announce that the next lecture under the aegis of the Center for the Study of Indian Knowledge Traditions is on July 3. It is by Professor Ramasubramaniam of IIT Bombay, and he will deliver a talk on India's contribution to mathematics. What you mentioned, Professor, Madhav, the entire Kerala school of mathematics, which I learned only recently, thanks to my very good friend Dr. Spenta Wadia. It is so fascinating, and that's just one part of our country, Kerala. I'm sure many other parts of India have also contributed to the growth of mathematics, to the growth of other branches of science, and all of this we must research. And not just research, as you mentioned, Professor, this must become part of our curriculum. From school to college to university, if you see our textbooks, do we ever see what our ancestors contributed to different streams of knowledge? No. That's why if you see the room in which we have established this center, we have actually recently collected all the textbooks, all the college textbooks, school textbooks, and we are going to study how much reference there is to India's contribution to different streams of knowledge. And we're going to present a report to government and urge that this must be changed. Otherwise, our children will grow up thinking that India did not contribute anything. We have only received from outside. We are simply consumers of knowledge coming from outside. We are not creators of knowledge. That's not true. We have created knowledge. As Professor Wahia showed us, as Professor Apte showed us, we have created knowledge, we have to create even more. And that is the purpose for which we have set up this center. And I urge you, friends, to contribute to our effort. By spreading the word around, by giving us suggestions, and by participating in all the other activities of ORF. Thank you very much.